Coming up, I'm going to talk about how I plan to supplement calcium and alkalinity for this tank. Okay, right now I have a young tank that is only 2 months old, but it is never too early to have a calcium and alkalinity supplementation plan in place. For my 187-gallon SPS dominant display, I use two-part, and the tank has been doing great, but it is sucking up the two-part to the tune of 250 mLs per day, and that is not cheap to maintain. So, with this new tank, I thought it would be more cost-efficient to use a calcium reactor. I have used calcium reactors in the past and have had really good results. However, they will lower a tank's pH, a potential drawback. How does a reactor lower pH? Well, carbon dioxide is injected into the reactor to lower pH to help dissolve calcium-based media inside. This calcium-rich liquid, or effluent, is then dripped back into the tank. Nonetheless, there are some things you can do to elevate the pH coming out of a reactor. One is to use kalkwasser. Hydroxide ions in the kalkwasser use carbon dioxide to increase alkalinity and as a result removes excess CO2 and increases pH. Kalkwasser can be added by running auto top off through a kalk reactor. I had this one from my Reef Creations sitting around, so I decided to put it back into action. I set the blue line pump to run 4 times during the overnight hours for 15 minutes a pop to stir the kalk. I did this to counteract the drop in pH when the tank lights are off. Anyway, the pump has been acting up despite a good cleaning, so we will see how long it will last. And believe it or not, I'm using this 15 to 20 year old, I don't know exactly how old it is, liter meter 3 for my auto top off. Let's keep the fingers crossed on that one. Okay, a second way to elevate pH is to have a second chamber on a calcium reactor to help absorb the excess carbon dioxide. I had good luck with a dual chamber calcium reactor in the past, so it is an important feature in my book. What you are looking at here is a brand new model of calcium reactor manufactured by Reef Octopus and distributed by CoralView. Both chambers on this Reef Octopus Varios CR3000 reactor are 7 inches wide and 19 inches tall, so you can fit a lot of media inside. My tank is 225 gallons, but the unit is actually rated for tanks up to 580 gallons, so yep, I plan to have a lot of SPS and a heavy demand for calcium and alkalinity. A couple of cool features I'd like to point out here. One is the built-in pH probe holder. I really like it because it will allow me via my GHL controller to shut off the CO2 if the pH inside the reactor gets too low. Hey, who knows, but it would be a bummer if something went wrong with my CO2 regulator. I really don't want to have a whole bunch of CO2 dumped into the tank. Another great feature are the screw-on lids. They are very easy to use, no annoying thumb screws to deal with. This reactor also comes with a Varios 4 variable speed pump that maxes out at 40 watts. The pump recirculates water upwards in a reverse flow, which is great since it prevents the media from compacting down on the bottom of the chamber. This not only improves the efficiency of the reactor, but it makes it much easier to clean when it is time to swap out the media. One other thing to note here, there is an effluent control valve that comes with this reactor, but I opted to pick up this Chemours peristaltic dosing pump for extra dosing precision. Even though I have no corals at this point, I have been running the reactor for the past few weeks, and I have to say I am loving it. It really has been a set it and forget it piece of equipment. My alkalinity has been rock solid, and now I'm starting to see a bunch of coralline algae grow on the bottom of the tank. A big shout out to reefing buddy Greg Carroll for turning me on to Reef Octopus calcium reactors. He knows his stuff. Lastly, I do want to mention that I'm in the process of having an air exchange unit installed in the house to help bring fresh air in and reduce the amount of carbon dioxide inside the house. This should certainly help boost pH, especially now that the windows are shut tight due to winter. Anyway, many thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so already. I'll put links to Marine Depot and Reefbum in the video description below. See you next time.